Hello everyone, in this video we will discuss all the activities of class 10th science chapter 2 acid base and salt. Previously मैंने chapter 1 की activity एक video में upload की थी और maximum students ने कहा कि मैम आप second chapter की भी बनाएं. So in this video we will discuss each and every activity of class 10th science second chapter acid base and salt and we will try to perform each and every activity with its conclusion, observation and result. So let's start the activity here. So the first activity here is acid and bases in the laboratory, for which we have to collect different acids here. These are HCl, H2SO4, HNO3, CH3COH, that is hydrochloric acid, sulfuric acid, nitric acid and acetic acid. Similarly, we have to collect the bases here, and the bases are sodium hydroxide, NaOH, calcium hydroxide, CaOH whole twice, potassium hydroxide, KOH, magnesium hydroxide, MgOH whole twice, and ammonium hydroxide, that is NH4OH. You must write formula of all these acid and base. Now the next step is to take the four watch glasses here. I have taken 1, 2, 3, 4, and I will add hydrochloric acid, a drop of hydrochloric acid on each watch glass. You can observe here. I'm adding the drop here. And now the next step is to add the indicator over it. So I have four indicator with me. So first step, I will add blue litmus over one watch glass, and you can observe here it turned red in color. Similarly, if I am adding here red litmus, then in case of acid, red will remain red. You can observe here, red will remain red. If I am adding phenolphthalein, then it will remain colorless. So for example, you can see the observe, there will be no change. And if I'm adding methyl orange, then again it turn red in color. You can observe here. So it turn red in color. So these are the observation here. So these are the observation. Red litmus remain red, blue litmus turns red, phenolphthalein remain colorless, methyl orange turn red. So if we perform activity with all these acid, the observation will remain same because all these four examples are acid. So now we directly move ahead for the bases. Now the next step is to add base on these watch glass. I have washed this watch glass. So now I am adding NaOH. And then the next step is to add the indicator. Now for example, I have taken the first indicator, that is litmus blue here. So since it is a base, so blue will remain blue here. You can observe it changes into blue in color. Similarly, if I am taking here the litmus red, so red changes into blue in color again. So it is red, but when it is just touching the base solution, it turns into blue in color. Now next one is the phenolphthalein. In case of acid it remain colorless, but in case of base it give a pink color solution. You can observe here, the drop reaches and it turn into pink in color. Then next one is the methyl orange. It is red in acid, but in case of base it turn the solution into yellow in color. So the drop reaches the solution and it turn it into yellow in color. So these are the observation for all the bases. These observation will remain same. That is red litmus turn blue, blue litmus remain blue, phenolphthalein turns pink in color, methyl orange turns into yellow color. So these are the observation which are common for all bases. I have taken here NaOH. If I will take any of this sample, the result will remain the same. So by this we conclude the activity 2.1 here. Now the next activity is activity 2.2, and it is based on the olfactory indicator. Now first one here is the visible indicator, that they give us a particular color. That is activity 2.1 is based on the color change of indicator in acid and base. Similarly, activity 2.2 is based on the indicators which are olfactory indicators, that they are giving a different smell in acid or a base. So here the samples they have taken are onion juice, clove oil and vanilla essence. Now for each sample they have kept the cloth dipped in these solution for overnight and next day. They are just giving a particular order. For example, onion have a specific order, clove has a specific order, vanilla has a specific order. Now we have to just add acid sample over the cloth dipped in onion. So now in case of acid, it will retain the smell, whereas in case of base, the order is completely destroyed and now it become odorless. So in all these cases, when we add acid on the cloth containing this smell, then they will retain the smell. But when we add base over that cloth, then it become odorless. So this is a simple activity where आपको एक कपड़ा लेना है जिसपे onion juice को आपने spread करना है और tightly bag में pack करके overnight fridge में रख देना है. Next day अब उस cloth में से smell आएगी, that is obvious because of onion or of a clove oil. अगर हम clove उस पर रखते हैं तो that is long जिसको हम बोलते हैं. अब हमने उसी कपड़े की सरफेस पे HCl को ऐड करना है और फिर स्मेल करके देखना है क्या हमें स्मेल आएगी. तो यस, इट विल रिटेन द स्मेल. वेयर एज अगर हम उसी क्लॉथ पे अनियन डिप और क्लोव ऑयल डिप पे अगर हम बेस ऐड कर रहे हैं तो नाउ इट बिकम ऑर्डरलेस, मींस अब उसमें कोई भी स्मेल नहीं आएगी. विच मीन्स ऑल्फैक्ट्री इंडिकेटर्स रिटेन देयर स्मेल इन एसिड बट बिकम ऑर्डरलेस इन बेसिक सॉल्यूशन. फिर चाहे वो वेनीला एसेंस क्यों ना हो, इन द सेम वे आपको इसमें ये कंक्लूजन लर्न करना है दैट इन एसिड दे ऑल विल रिटेन देयर स्मेल, उनमें स्मेल आएगी, बट इन बेसिक सॉल्यूशन दे ऑल बिकम ऑर्डरलेस, दे विल नॉट गिव अ पर्टिकुलर स्मेल. नाउ नेक्स्ट एक्टिविटी इज एक्टिविटी 2.3 विच इज बेस्ड ऑन द फैक्ट दैट हाउ डू एसिड एंड बेसिस रिएक्ट विद द मेटल. So the here we have to take the zinc granules and they are added into dilute esterase of 4. Then we have to observe that what happened. We have to name the gas which is evolved and what happened if we have taken acetic acid HCl or HNO3. So let's start the activity here. So we add zinc granules. And then we will add sulfuric acid into it. And then we'll place this over it and we will observe the change. You can see here a gas is formed which is when passed through soap solution, a bubble is formed. So you can observe here a gas is and a bubble is formed. So you can observe here a gas bubble is formed because as acid react with the metal, it form a salt and release hydrogen gas. So this gas when passed through a soap solution, then a bubble is formed. This soap bubble contain hydrogen gas in it. So when we bring a burning candle near to this bubble, it bursts with a pop sound, which confirms that it contains hydrogen gas in it. Now the next step is to perform this reaction with three different acid, HNO3, acetic acid and HCl. So I am taking HCl, I am taking zinc granule in each of the test tube. And now I will add acid, a specific acid in each one of them. For example, what happened if we add HNO3 into an zinc granules, then there will be evolution of a gas, but it is of brown color. You can observe some brownish color is there. That is, here instead of hydrogen gas, nitrogen oxide is formed. This is one of the exception that only in case of HNO3, the brown color fumes are obtained. This you will do in your chapter 3rd also, that in case of nitric acid, it will release a brown color fumes. Now the next step is to add HCl. So if we add HCl, then there will be an evolution, but the reaction here is bit slower than that of the H2SO4. Hydrogen gas is releasing here also. You can observe the change. And gas is forming and releasing out there. Acid which we have to take is the acetic acid. So when we add the acetic acid, then also reaction will take place. But now the speed of reaction is very slower than that of HCl. You can observe here, it takes time to form hydrogen gas. It will react, but it reacts slowly. In comparison to HCl, if I am taking here HCl, you can see the difference here. In case of HCl, it is reacting. In case of HCl, it is reacting, whereas in acetic acid, it is also reacting, but reacting with a slower pace. Now, why this happens? So, this is an important point, that all react with the same speed. So, answer will be no. All the three react at a different and give the different product. For example, acetic acid is a weak acid. It reacts less vigorously. Here it is forming zinc acetate and release hydrogen gas. Whereas in case of HCl, it is forming ZnCl2 and H2 gas is released. And in case of nitrate, a brown color fumes of nitrogen dioxide is formed here. This is an important observation. All acid react with the metal and release hydrogen gas except HNO3. And the next part of it, what happened if we pass this H2 gas in a soap solution, then it forms a hydrogen gas. If we bring a burning candle near to it, it bursts with a pop sound. So this is the observation, that when gas is passed through a soap solution, it forms a bubble where hydrogen gas is trapped in it, and if we bring burning candle near to it, it bursts with a pop sound. Now the next activity here is activity 2.4. Now this activity is similar as the previous one. We have to take the zinc granules, and now we will add this into a base, and we have to record our observation. Now the next step is to take the NaOH, and we are adding this solution in the test tube, and then I will add zinc granules into it and observe the change here. So what happened in this case? Sodium hydroxide reacts with zinc and forms sodium zincate. Again, hydrogen gas is released, and when this hydrogen gas is passed through a soap solution, then a bubble is formed in which hydrogen gas is trapped, and if we bring a burning candle near to it, then again it bursts with a pop sound. So observation for acid as well as for a base, both are same, that hydrogen gas is released, and if we pass that gas into a soap solution, a hydrogen bubble is formed which bursts with a pop sound. Now the next is activity 2.5, where we have to take two solid salt, that is, one is sodium carbonate, that is a salt here, and other one is sodium bicarbonate, that is sodium hydrogen carbonate NaHCO3. So we will take both these in a separate test tube. For example, in one test tube I will take the sodium carbonate Na, and in the next test tube I will take sodium hydrogen carbonate, and then we will add an acid into it. So we are taking here dilute HCl, for example, and now we are adding HCl into this and will observe the change. So when we add HCl into it, then there is an evolution of gas is there, evolution of gas is there. In both the cases, the gas evolved here is carbon dioxide, and when the carbon dioxide is passed through a lime water, it turns lime water milky. So the reaction with the sodium carbonate here is Na2CO3 plus HCl forming NaCl, carbon dioxide and water here. Similarly, sodium bicarbonate, that is NaHCO3 plus HCl, also forming NaCl, water and carbon dioxide. In both the cases, the carbon dioxide is released, and when this carbon dioxide is passed through lime water, it turns lime water milky. So this is the observation for activity 2.5 here. Now next is the activity 2.6, where we have to show the reaction between the acid and base. So in the first step, we have to take NaOH. So I am taking NaOH on the watch glass, and then I will add phenolphthalein. Here we have in the first activity mein bhi kiya tha, that on NaOH, the phenolphthalein will give us a pink color. So the drop reaches, it gave us the pink color. Now this become a solution 1 here, solution 1. Now in the solution 1 we have to add HCl, so I'm adding a few drops of HCl, and you can observe the change here. The point is, reacting, it become colorless because it is neutralizing the solution. So in NaOH base it is neutralizing, so now this solution become acidic because phenolphthalein is colorless here. So now it become a solution 2 here. Now in the solution 2 if I will add NaOH, then what happened? Then again a neutralization reaction will take place. The drop reaching the solution is turning pink in color, and when neutralization is complete and solution become basic, it again regain pink color here. You can observe here. Now solution will become pink in color. Now these are the questions related to this activity. What is the color of solution when we add phenolphthalein NaOH? It become pink in color. Add dilute solution drop by drop. Is there any color change? Yes, it become colorless. Why did the color of phenolphthalein change after adding an acid? Because acid is neutralizing the base and now solution become acidic in nature. Hence it is colorless. Add a few drop of NaOH in the above mixture. Then we have again add. Does the pink color of phenolphthalein reappear? Yes, pink color reappear. And now if we discuss regarding the conclusion from this activity, that the solution 1 is basic, hence phenolphthalein appears pink in color here. In the second solution when we add HCl, now it become acidic, hence it become colorless solution. Then we have added NaOH, now again it become basic and hence it appears pink in color. The phenolphthalein give two colors, in acid it is colorless, in base it is pink, and this whole reaction is a neutralization reaction. Now next is the activity 2.7 where copper oxide is mixed with HCl. So this is a metal oxide. When it reacts with the water it acid, it is a metal oxide. When it is react with an acid it forms salt and water, that is CuO plus HCl forming CuCl2 and water. So this is the reaction. What happened when metal oxide react with an acid? It forms salt and water here. So in chapter 2nd there are almost 15 activities and we have covered all the 7 activities here. I hope you are able to understand all these activities with proper presentations and able to write the observation in each case. It is very important because nowadays these questions are framed in a form of case based question, where some activity is given to you and options are there. So these observations are very much important. Kindly try to learn these observations and write in a table form in your copy. Thank you everyone.